Well, I was down in my hometown with a buddy just passing through. And the local haze put us in a daze, so I had to stop for a brew. Well, there's a tavern on every corner, the steel mill saw to that. So I aimed my car at a brand new bar out there between the tracks. I ordered up a tall one, my buddy, he done the same. About a dozen or so regular folks was waiting on the football game. Then a little black dog laying on the floor, soaking up the atmosphere. It was a perfect January day to sit and have a beer. Well, after a while, this fella comes by and hands me a sheet. Said for a couple of bucks, if your numbers come up, the pot is yours to keep. I tipped my glass, I said I'd pass. I wasn't feeling lucky that day. So he gave it to a woman sitting by the dog, and she said, okay. Woman took that football pool and she gave it a look. Then she put her name on a couple of squares that no one had took. And then she handed it down to the dog. Dog put her paw on the square. And the woman bought that dog in the football pool right then and there. Well, one beer led to another, another one led to some more. And we sat and talked philosophy while we was watching the football score. When the game was done, I think Tennessee won. The crowd let out a cheer, because the dog had won that football pool and bought everybody a beer. The moral of this story, the moral of this song, is if you think you've seen everything, you might be wrong. And if you're ever stuck in Whiting, Indiana, you may say it stinks. But it's the only place in the whole dang world a dog might buy you a drink. Yes, it's the only place in the whole dang world dog might buy you a drink.